Hey everyone, Vinayak here. I have with me the Insta 360 One R, which is the twin edition, and I've been waiting for this for quite some time now. And this one is one of the best action cameras that you can get. We'll find out in this video why.
This is the Insta 360 One R, an action cam that completely changes the way we look at action cameras. It can do everything an action cam can, as these images would indicate on the side. Cycling, travel, snowboarding and biking, and much more of course. This is the Indian imported version and we can register for warranty via insta360india.com. So what's so special about this camera? The answer is hidden under this slip. The camera has a modular design, which means we have a core where all the processing takes place and also has the display. A camera module of which we have three options, but my twin edition has two. The 360 camera and a 4K action camera. Features are 5.7K 360 degree capture, wide angle lens, flow state stabilization, waterproof up to 5 meters or 16.4 feet. This can erase the selfie stick from your recordings, which is cool. AI editing in the app and a whole host of other features. Let's open it up. Here we go. On the top, we have the core module with the 4K action cam. Next is the 360 degree camera module, and under that is the battery. 1190 mAh. These are the battery terminals or contacts that would line up with the core module and power the entire setup. Do not drop into fire. Well, lithium ion batteries are volatile, so don't drop any battery into fire anyway. Nice and sleek. Next, we have the 360 module. It's got two cameras, each pointing in the opposite direction, which would each record a hemispherical video, and the two are combined to create a 360 degree video. I did have the Gear 360 by Samsung earlier, but that doesn't have the kind of quality this camera would provide. F2.0 and 7.2mm equivalent lens, which is moderately bright and is quite wide. Flow State is Insta's own stabilization solution, and it's quite awe-inspiring the kind of videos that are created using this camera. This is the side that would attach the battery, and here are the contacts that would attach the module to the core. Here's the core module pre-attached to the 4K module. This module acts like a standard 4K action cam. Get the protective film off the lens, and the same for the display on the core. Quite sleek. It's actually smaller than I thought it would be. Here's how the connectors line up underneath where the battery docks. 4K wide angle f2.8 with 16.4mm FOV. 16.4, it's around the sweet spot for vlogging. Pull apart and we have them separate now. This is how the connectors look. Another cool feature is that if you're vlogging, you would like to see yourself while shooting. So just turn the display around and bam, you have a front facing display. On the top of the core, we have the power and record buttons. Quite accessible, the record button especially. The power button is a bit smaller, maybe not to have the camera turn off accidentally. Let's snap on the battery and that's it. I'm surprised that this camera is even waterproof due to its modular design. There is a caveat though, it needs to be in the provided cage, which I'll show in some time, which holds the pieces together for waterproofing. Okay, hold down the power button, it's on. The display is a touchscreen, so let me select English. We need to link it to a phone using the Insta 360 One app. No SD card, we'll insert one and the display is small, but enough to know where you're shooting. But if you're using the 360 mod, you don't even have to worry about that as it records everything. All the menu options are available via swipes. Swipe down for the main settings menu. Swipe left for camera settings to set white balance and exposure. Swipe right for the media gallery. Bottom left icon, select capture mode, and bottom right is for the resolution settings. It's easy to use once you get used to it. Let's see what else is in the box. A USB-C cable. No power brick as with most action cameras. Stickers. And a cover to store your lens mods. What else do we have? Ah, at last, the mounting case and also documentation. A Insta360 cleaning cloth, which is quite necessary as the lenses are prone to pick up fingerprints. Here's the mounting case. You would insert the Insta360 ONE R within and it would keep the components together for the waterproofing. So slide the switch on top, open the case, slide in the camera, make sure the buttons are aligned, and done. Also, the bottom of the case has this mounting bracket which works with almost, if not all, action camera accessories. These are the lens covers for the 360 module. Nice that they included it. Slide it on and it's protected. These can be used even when the module is attached to the core. The rest of the mounting accessories are standard pin-based attachment. And the mount has a tripod screw hole at the bottom. On the side, we have a lock cover where we find the USB-C port and the micro SD card slot. Let me get the camera out so that we have a better view. Notice these two arrows are pointing at each other. This is the orientation we need to lock the cover back on. If the cover is not locked properly, it's not waterproof anymore. Let me put this memory card in temporarily. I'll have to look for a 128GB card later, as 32GB is not going to be enough while shooting in 5.7K. Slide it in and close. Another cool feature on this lock is this yellow color here. If the lock is not installed properly, you will notice this yellow color. If it's in properly, it will be black. There are times that the lock door is completely out of the slot and it looks black. Make sure it's completely inserted before use. Let's set up the camera. We need to activate it via the app. Install Insta360 app. Allow permissions. Make sure Bluetooth and Wi-Fi are on. Select 1R in the Bluetooth list. And after this, the phone would connect directly to the camera's Wi-Fi and the camera is activated. If the phone doesn't connect to the camera's Wi-Fi automatically, you can open up Wi-Fi settings and manually select 1R Wi-Fi hotspot. Once connected, we can view the live feed of the camera. So this is the 4K camera, looks quite nice. The video is compressed while transmitting through Wi-Fi, but internally the camera is recording in the resolution you have selected. Now let's shift to the 360 degree camera. You can pan and tilt in every direction without the camera even needing to move, which is fantastic. We have a lot of preset stories, as they are called, where we can have effects applied to the footage recorded on the camera. The best part is that the effects are added in post, so we can still have the original footage, and also we can apply multiple effects if you want later. Exporting on the phone gives you only a 1080p video. But if you need more quality, use the Insta360 Studio application on the PC. At least you'll get 4K over there. It's also nice that you don't need to download the video to the phone before editing, saving the already precious space on your phone. This is how photographs look from the Insta360. This is taken on the 360 mod, and the other is from the 4K mod. The camera uses its own INSV format and the application installs the appropriate drivers on Windows for enabling thumbnails on the files, and we can also edit on the PC. We also have an Adobe Premiere plugin to use these INSV files directly within Premiere. Connecting the camera is where I had a bit of a problem. Even though it was connected, it was not showing up as a drive on Windows. Then after a bit of digging in the menus, I found the USB mode option and turned on U-Disk to enable using the camera as an external drive. Much easier than having to remove the microSD card and put it back in. The lock cover is a pain to open and close, especially if it's within the mounting case. The effects are fun to use and the AI processes the files quite well. The 360 video at 5.7K is for the whole 360 degree video and not for only one direction. So if you point it in a certain direction in post, the resolution is lower than 5.7K. The reframing option is quite nice and you never miss a thing when recording in 360, as you can turn the camera in any direction you want to in post. The seam lines though are visible, seems to be processing better on the PC.
Battery life is around 70 minutes, which is normal I guess for action cameras. You can purchase a boosted battery, which can be very expensive. Another option is to use a power bank instead if you're not stuck in the rain or interacting with water in any way. Getting the camera in and out of this cage is irritating, but if you need waterproofing and the mount, you do need this.
Voice control is another cool feature that you have on this camera. Start and stop recording using your voice. But the feature needs to be activated in the menu before you can use it. I turned it off as it could stop recording if there was too much noise outside. Also, make sure to select a language or the voice controls will not work.
The camera with its little niggles is still a very capable camera, which is why it's earned its name as the best action camera. The 360 degree mod is fun to use, and the effects that you can create automatically via the app is also fantastic. I went for the twin edition because the 4K camera was being bundled for less than 4K more than the price of the 360 module. Another advantage of the modular design is that newer modules can be designed to bring in new features. I really love this camera and would actually like to travel around and take more shots. But you know what's going on right now, so I can't leave my house. So these are the only ones that I have for now. As usual, if you have any questions, do write into me at tech@talkingstuff.net or WhatsApp me at 96525-78833. Also, make sure to like, subscribe, and also hit the notification bell to be notified when new videos are added. Thank you for watching, and see you all next time.